cries every and tears and, you know, and right?
I'm there sorry. I'm sorry. It's fine.
I'm not editing this. That's the cat.
It's Bella.
That's the cat. Bella, move away.
The puma.
Yeah,
okay.
So, hello. I have...
Hi.
How are you, Plamena? Good?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Good, good. So thank you for taking the time for this and for making
it's a pleasure.
Thank you for the for making this video. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and your business?
Hi everyone. My name is Plamena Vojmirova and I'm currently in Sofia, situated in Sofia, Bulgaria. I'm a designer, founder, and CEO in the Blackout label, which is currently doing industrial macrame stuff.
Okay.
For
nice.
For all the way to jewelries, dresses, and clothes.
Okay.
To how to say this? Interior design accessories.
All right.
Like this stuff.
Yeah, like wall decoration.
Yeah.
Table accessories.
Tables. Chairs, carpets, pillows, everything like this from macrame.
Very nice. Very nice. Good.
Yeah.
Good, good. And so you're based in Sofia, right?
I'm based in Sofia, but I'm working with the whole world, so it doesn't matter where I'm based. So yeah. Currently, I'm also working as a designer and a stylist. So yeah, it's kind of interesting stuff. So I'm also making. I used to make before this happened, like workshops for children and for adults who are interested in knowing how to make macrame knots.
Ah, nice.
Yeah,
nice. So basically, working with your hands on the textile.
Yeah, always. Very
nice.
Always.
That's very nice. Yeah. That's very nice. And how did this come to you? What is your background? How did you start all of this? Like, what's
it's
the
very funny. It's very funny because my parents and my upbringing is totally engineering. They are engineers, people who like math and not very into the arts.
Yeah.
So it was like kind of how to say this? It was very funny when my first degree, I have a bachelor degree in technical university for, textile engineering.
All right.
First, my first degree is textile engineering, and after this, I go to New Bulgarian University here, and my second degree is bachelor degree in arts and design. Okay. So it was kind of funny because all my folks they say you're not a designer. How come you're just a person who came from engineering
lineage of people, you know.
I think
we all have the same parents. You're either a lawyer, doctor, or an engineer, otherwise you're not anything.
It was very funny because back in 2008 I was currently in States. I was in the States when the first crisis appeared.
Crisis.
I was there back at the time. And when I say to all the people that I was working there for like 6 months. Mm-hmm. And they told me, what is your degree? And they told me, and I said, yeah, I'm an engineer. And the reaction to the folks there were like, oh, your parents must be very, very rich.
Because that's, of course, engineering over there. Yeah.
When I said to my dad this over the phone, he said, yeah, probably we should all go to the States. I come from normal family of engineers and people who are not looking at the same way as I'm looking to the arts stuff.
I see.
So, how to say this?
I see.
I was never into very, very arty, ladylike stuff. I was more into men stuff. That's why how I started the whole thing. I started with to make this kind of macrame with industrial materials, which are visibly suitable only for guys.
Okay.
And you can find them in the hardware and everywhere. But
Nice. Yeah. But I went through some of the links. By the way, guys, I'm gonna put the links for Plamena's links and everything. So check out the links. Yeah. And if they want to connect with you, they can check out the Facebook page, of course, and they can connect with you.
And Instagram and LinkedIn. And we also are uploading our site. website is going to be a huge difference after this started.
Perfect.
We're making everything new, so the site will be available very soon.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. That's really amazing. That's really amazing. That you're still actually in the vibe of creating with your hands. There's not a lot of people now trying to do this. Everybody's trying to go through the easy way. I need to produce 100,000 units. Otherwise,
yeah, for
I'm not
sure.
Producing.
For sure.
And
people
so,
are very into because we're living in this kind of society. We used to actually live in this kind of society where everything is slow fashion was not in so.
Yeah.
So high in the priorities, you know, people like H&M, Zara, stuff like this, they want to go buy fast and
nice cat.
This was Miss Bella. Yeah. This was Miss Bella.
Miss Bella,
the
blackout team. Nice. The blackout cat. Now, I used to have a small black cat when I used to live back in France, and I named him Ozzy after Ozzy Osbourne because he was very violent. He used to chase the small poodles in the building. He used to go the small bulldogs, like smaller dogs, the tekels, the Yorkshires.
She's actually worse than a dog.
I think black cats don't know that they're cats. I think they think they're some kind of lions or something.
Yeah, they think they're pumas or something like
that. Yeah, they think they're big, and because even my cat was fighting against sometimes dogs twice his size.
For sure,
and
for sure.
You know,
the same time when I got her, she was very small, very small. I got her from a friend of mine.
Yeah.
From my birth town, and she was very scared because she was only a couple of weeks.
Yeah, yeah.
And we had to transport her all the way through Bulgaria to get her to me.
Wow.
And she went here, she was very stressed, and we went to the vet, and the vet was like my father's age, very big guy. And the minute he opened the cage, it was like,
It's
like so small thing, like a tiger.
So going back to textile, as you said, slow fashion wasn't very much a big thing, and everybody was more around fast fashion. Like you have to consume, and nobody now buys. Like I'm pretty sure that your parents, like my parents, still. I mean, my father has still the suit that he wore for his wedding. My mother has, my grandmother used to keep all her clothes. We still have towels and paper mats,
of course,
and stuff like this from 30, 40 years ago. And now you don't see that anymore. I call it the IKEAization of the society. It means that you buy cheap and disposable, and basically it's...
Everything is disposable. You see, it's the same with the food industry.
Absolutely.
And what we're looking and what we're reading, everything is fast. Like the minute all the Facebook and social media came in, they absolutely make the life a little bit easier, a lot more easier, the information is all around.
Yeah.
But because of all of this information is all around the world and it's so easy to access, people started being not that picky. You know, you go everywhere, you eat, or you just buy something,
absolutely.
No matter what, after this, I'm going to throw it away.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately, it's the same with the feelings, you know?
Yeah.
People nowadays are like priorities.
Tinder,
like
swipe right, swipe left. Swipe left, swipe right, swipe left. I know people that don't even know how to communicate and make a decent conversation.
People don't want to make commitments anymore for anything. It's like the same as the business stuff, is the relationship stuff, all of this. That's why when I started with the slow fashion or something that is so, taking time assuming and consuming, and people tell me, why don't you just, produce one style and you go like around the world?
No. Yeah.
Hundreds of, pairs of this. And I say, I don't want anybody to care what I'm having. So why is I'm going to do it?
Absolutely.
And it was in my brand politics. And when I started back in 2014, it was very hard. It was really, really hard because I was a small brand. I was working on my own. Most of the time, nobody believed in what I'm doing.
Yes.
Back in that time, social media marketing was not that of a big deal, especially not in Bulgaria. And when I started to, even explaining to my folks what I'm doing with the branding stuff, that it takes up to 3 to 5 years to get the name. And after this, to be politically correct to your brand and what your main idea is, people were like, fucking crazy. Yeah. It's not going to work this way. Just make something and sell it right away. Yeah. It was funny because back at that time, a lot of people tried to, you know, copy paste my stuff. Yeah. They sell some stuff and after probably a couple of months, they died, you know?
Yeah.
Not literally died, because their companies.
Their companies, well, because they need fast, because
today, yeah, they listen, need fast and they make one stuff in different, you know, not even styles, you know, different colors.
Yeah. Yeah.
They sell it and, you know, the niche was like overwhelmed,
yeah,
you know, the same stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So let's say I'm going to stick to it. No matter what.
Indeed. So resilience and patience, basically. That's what you're promoting in your business.
It was not easy.
Yeah.
It was not easy.
I can imagine.
There were times when, believe me, even I struggled with what I believed in. It was hard.
That's what people see. I mean, if I went through some of the links that you sent me and I've seen even the evolution of the person, you know, even your evolution as a person.
It's funny.
And people when they see you in that, people when they see your profile picture, check out, for example, her profile picture on Facebook. And people think, okay, so she's born into this and life and that's it. No. It took her, she's saying 2004, 2008, she came back from the States. So it took her literally
2008, years. I started making this stuff 2010, probably the first
time. Okay, so 10 years. So 10 what, years. What we're 10 talking years. To right now is the result of 10 years of labor and work and cries
every
and
day.
Tears and, you know, and right?
I'm there sorry. We go. I'm sorry.
It's fine. I'm not editing this. That's the cat.
It's Bella.
That's the cat. Bella, move away.
The Puma. Yeah,
okay.
Okay.
So
it's 10 years.
So it's been 10 years. So what people see now is basically 10 years.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
It's cool. It's okay. Don't worry. I'm not going to edit this. I will start.
Yeah, this will be a fast one. I'm just going to take her because she's probably doing this again. This is Miss Bella. Say hi,
hey.
Miss Bella. Hi.
Hey,
she's so bored.
Yeah. So, okay. How do you see, for example, the impact of, because you touched on something between slow and fast fashion and the difference between your brand and Zara and all the other brands. And so how do you see the evolution for your brand or slow fashion in general with COVID-19, where people are very picky now, they're trying to...
Yeah, they're trying to escape
the
COVID-19. So it's very funny that we're living in this kind of, you know, times. For me, this is a kind of a big opportunity in this time for a real, statement brands to get in. Far behind the voice. Actually, I see this as an opportunity of what is real will survive, what not will definitely die.
Okay. A lot of Instagram influencers and YouTube gurus are gonna be looking for jobs in 6 months. So
for sure. It's very funny because my life in general was kind of living in isolation. It was self-isolation because when you're an artist or a creator, you literally need to distance yourself from society in a way to produce something that is not already seen. You have to be on your own. And my dad, we used to fight about this a lot of times because, as you see, I'm a young woman. I'm in a way to, you know, have children, boyfriend, all this stuff.
Yeah.
And he said to me, it's not normal. It's not normal for you to be 8 months in a year completely isolated from people, to work every day, no days off, no time off, all day working. And when I started, it was very funny because you work and you don't know if you're going to be paid. So you do it anyways.
You
started to do it. And back at that time, I used to read a lot of books with people who are entrepreneurs and they started from the scratch. They don't have anything. They say all of this. You start no matter what. You start no matter if you're going to be paid or not.
And the cat is about to.
And you do it because you want to do it, not because you say you're going to be paid. And for me, this kind of isolation right now, I'm very happy that it happens right now because it's going to be very, very crucial for the business, for the e-commerce, for the all of the brands. Right now, people who are more in tune and what is happening and what the society will need after this, because let's face it, nobody will stop buying stuff.
Yeah.
You just have to, you know, see what is coming.
Yeah.
In order to do this, you have to know what happened exactly 10 years ago with the crisis before this.
Yeah.
It was a crisis. Yeah. And nobody told us that we're going to be in a crisis.
Yeah.
I was 19 years old back then. And I was like a teenager when I got to the States. And for me, being that young in that kind of position, I was like, oh, wow, this is huge.
Indeed.
This is huge. What is happening?
Indeed. Indeed.
I came back here in Bulgaria, and my folks, my friends were like 19, they want to go to parties, they wanted us, and I said to them, a huge crisis is coming, and knowing where we are in Bulgaria, we won't survive this, or we will be recovering this for like 10 years.
Yeah.
Exactly the same things happened. Yeah. So, no matter where you are right now, no matter what are you doing, you can always reboot yourself.
Yeah.
For the brands, for me, it's crucial.
Absolutely.
For you to get in touch in what are your brand, what are your brand ideas back at this time? What you stay for? What are your main things that are making you more recognizable?
Wow. Okay.
For me, when I started this, when I started the branding stuff, I knew that the name of the brand should be something that is more equal or more huge than just whatever jewelry is by Clement of Woodmere.
Yeah.
I don't want my name to be in this stuff. I want to
absolutely
be huge enough to make me believe in something that is groundbreaking, that is something new, and at the same time, it will be enough for me to develop in other areas, such
absolutely
as interior, such as...
I always say this to my anybody I work with, I always say when you're creating a company, it's like, listen, it's like having, I don't have kids.
I do have
a girlfriend, but I don't have a plan of kids anytime like in the next 6 months. And I always tell people that, listen, you have kids and one day they're 4 and they're 5 and they're 6 and 7. And then you want them to be a mathematics genius or you want them to be an astrophysicist. And then they pick up a guitar, or they start playing the piano, and then boom, everything changes.
For sure.
The company is the same. Actually, you create a company with the idea of what you convey as your values into the company.
Yeah.
But then the company will develop and will become its own identity, right?
Yeah. Sorry again.
It's okay. That's the cat. So the company will develop into its own identity, I think, right?
Yeah, for sure. It's like a little kid. It's like a little kid. Again, I'm very, very happy that you pointed this out. It's like a kid when you given birth to a kid. I'm also not a mom, but I have been raising kids on my own. So I know. So when you become a mom, you have this huge idea about your kid.
Yeah.
That you want to be the great physician, the greatest doctor out of the world.
Yeah.
Or whatever. But he or she turned to be like an artist or a performer or
absolutely.
IT. It's the same when I started my brand. Let's say I started the brand because I wanted something on my own. I wanted to be to be more recognizable in a way of how I was dressing, because I was never dressing like the normal girls.
Oh, so interesting. So you created the brand so the brand started on your own image.
Yeah, it started on my own image.
And wow, okay.
That went with 2010, when I got the idea about the stuff. I'm sorry again, she's very, very interesting.
Well, I'm taking all the attention, so she doesn't like that.
She wants the attention, of course. Yeah. So when I started, back in 2010, I started with a very huge, very, very huge jewelries from the ropes. Back in 2010, you know, you look how I see.
Yeah.
You see my look. So
yeah.
For me, this is okay. But if you see somebody who is a little bit, you know, smaller, petite person. So back when I started, it was very funny, you know?
Yeah.
And if I continue to do this with the huge jewelries, I will be probably won't selling anything.
Mm.
It started okay, but the niche back then, the market was not only for big jewelries. People weren't ready for this kind of stuff already, like in 2010. So if I was about to make this a brand,
yeah,
and a working brand, I should be looking at my clients, like the whole.
So it cannot be about you anymore. It has to be about the people.
Person. Yeah, not only one person, not yeah. only me.
Yeah.
So I started making stuff that are more suitable for everybody.
Mm.
Of course, not for everybody, but yeah. you know, for this petite person, for this huge person, for whatever. For men, for women, for children. And like this, after this, I realized that it was not only about the jewelry, you know, mm. the jewelry is mm. just one part of the piece of the puzzle. And after this, I started with design, interior yeah. designer stuff,
nice.
And with clothes, and with the macrame workshops. So
nice.
it was all like raising a kid, you know, following the steps, no matter what.
Absolutely. And now you're raising a cat.
So, yeah, she came in the perfect timing.
Yeah. Well, I'd rather have her on this side of the camera than rather than behind the camera and pushing it off.
I hope so too, but she, you know, she's a puma. You yeah. can never understand where she will be.
Absolutely. Yeah. So what can you give us, like, if you're like, how's your forecast for the next years for your business? What do you think are going to be the changes in the market that you're serving? And what do you think people that are in this industry, design, creatives, working with their own hands, what do you think we should be looking for? If talking to the audience.
Yeah. As I said before, the brands who are more like brand aware, like having ideas on what makes them different, they will be successful next year. Because yeah. people after this crisis, they want something more sustainable.
Okay.
They will be looking for something that will pass the time, not only for like 2 weeks, because
okay.
you see right now we're in the stage where we're looking at what we're giving our money to,
yeah.
you know, even the traders and everything. This is a huge crisis, like economical crisis that is coming, and mm-hmm. people will be looking at something that is staying in the time no matter what. They will
okay.
be looking for a legacy. In my opinion, if you want to have a business who is right now thriving, not going down under, you will be having to go completely online, or probably looking what is going on around the world,
mm.
you will have to look in the forecasts about the people and what are their preferences going to be for okay. the next year and a half, mm. probably
so,
two.
So you would look at. So you would look into the behavior of the people,
yeah, for
and,
sure.
and shape it. And you're forecasting that people, it's indeed, it makes sense. People will be looking to make a relationship with brands. I had a talk
with
the
brands,
yeah.
not only via influencers, because right
no,
now.
No. A relationship like I want to wear something that also represents my values, you know, like
of course,
if you
sure.
know Nike, for example, just do it. So yes, if I'm a just do it
yeah.
person, I will wear Nike. So that's the,
sure.
that's the idea.
You have to have a strong logo. You have to have a strong, not only the logo,
mm.
but you have the main idea.
Mm.
For me, the main idea of my brand is I want to be seen.
Mm.
This is what I stand for. I want to be seen, no matter if I'm wearing this jewelry,
mm.
no matter if I'm wearing this dress or whatever.
Mm.
I want to be seen no matter what.
I understand.
I'm embracing who I am. This
I
is
understand.
What I stand for. No matter if there is a crisis, no matter what this, it's for me, it's very crucial right now to stand exactly where you are,
yeah.
to remember your values,
yeah.
In a way of a business values,
yeah.
to give out free content, but not free enough for your clients,
yeah.
to be motivated, to
yeah.
motivate them to stay with you, because
yeah.
for at the end of the day, the clients make the brand.
Yeah. Yeah. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, indeed. Indeed, you
and
are what you're producing.
Time, yeah, at the same time, try to be as more as creative as you are. More even more creative than you are right now. Try to, you know, use this crisis in order to reboot yourself, to improve yourself, and in order to be better as a brand.
Yeah, I think as you said, you're completely right. I think what people are gonna face now is their own person, is their own ego, is the person looking at them in the mirror.
For sure.
So I don't know. You're too young to remember this, but there are some wars that happened in Europe in the early 90s. And,
and I remember, I'm not that young.
No, okay, but like, I mean, you didn't live through it. Your parents more lived through it. You were a kid in the 90s. And so, those wars, when they happened, you have, for example, surgeons and doctors that became taxi drivers in other countries. You have, you see what I mean? And so that's adaptation is like, okay, you look at yourself in the mirror and you say, okay, now I have to take care of business. Like I have to take care of family and kids. So I don't have time for this. And so people were more practical back then. And today we make emotional decisions, you know? So I think we're going to go back to a little bit more practical things. I'm already seeing it. The do-it-yourself videos on YouTube are amazingly booming. Like the do-it-yourself, how to make your own table, how to make your own chair, you know? So people are sitting at home and creators will create. That's when I talked to Brandon a couple of days ago. Creators will create. That's the world that we live in. So let's good.
Yeah.
So what would be like if we have to summarize your forecast of the things, and if you had just one thing you want to share with the audience before we end this interview, what would be it? Like, what would be the one thing you want everybody that's following you and your brand to retain?
Stay in your true colors.
Okay.
No matter what, the forecast will be always be sunny when you're in your own colors.
Okay. So that's perfect. Let's not change anything for that. Okay, I'll stop the recording now. Thank you for taking the time for this, but let's